Με από τα κρίκια ούστε. Μα δεν είναι φόκ του με σπίκια. Μην σκέψεις το πόμπι. Ρούτες είναι το πόμπι. Ούστε ρέκκιν κατ' το πόλι στο τσόμπι.
Welcome to Vinyl Fugazi, your weekly internet toy review show, bringing you the best in the world of vinyl toys, collectibles, urgent urban culture, and design. Bringing you the best in the world of vinyl toys, collectibles, urban culture, and design. Hi, Jimmy. How you doing?
Not too bad.
This is episode 2, and I hope you liked our Dunny Azteca 2 intro. We have a lot of wonderful toys and things to review today. I know I'm feeling wonderful. Jimmy, how you feeling?
Not too bad. The weather's getting better.
Yeah, we wanted to, you might notice our Minnesota Twins blanket here and our TC caps. We didn't even talk about where we were from. And we are from the cold northern state of Minnesota, the Twin Cities. But there's a lot of wonderful things about it. The Twin Cities up here.
Boobs and baseball. Right now, we ain't got much of each, but one's coming for sure, and I hope the other's going to follow.
Boobs. Baseball. Yeah, it's been just miserable cold, but you know what?
Record snowfall this year.
Yeah, record snowfall this year. We've had 2 or 3 huge snowstorms, but you know, we have a really good art scene here with the Walker Art Center and with a lot of things going on. We lost our toy store in the Twin Cities, which was actually called Robot Love.
I said we lost our kid robot closed. I meant Robot Love. I apologize.
Last week, Jimmy made a little slip up there, but you know, we miss them a lot, and we don't really have a vinyl store. We go to Tamagotchi now, which is close to us, and we buy our blind boxes there. But
yeah, Denny there, pretty awesome.
Yeah, Denny's pretty cool. We have no sponsors. Monkey Butt Powder dropped us after last week, and we have no fans, no new fans on Facebook. But you know, that's the way we like it. No, it's not the way we like it. Please email us at vinylfugazi@gmail.com. I'm trying to get the link on the Facebook page, you know, so you don't have to type in the email. But please, vinylfugazi@gmail.com. And we will review your toy, your art, your drawing. Send us a box with something in it. Anything that you found out that we might not know about, you know, let us know and we'll cover it. And I also wanted to say that Vinyl Fugazi on Facebook, just type it in. You can leave your own reviews or pictures or anything on there. I left it open to the public, so you can just go on there and post something.
Just do something.
Absolutely. Should we get into the toy reviews, Jimmy?
All right, let's go.
All right. The first toy that we're going to review is the Buona Spoons. Say what? He's actually a guy from Grass Hut over on the West Coast,
Oregon.
That's
his name, Buona Spoons?
Mm-hmm.
Nice.
And he's really well known for doing a lot of resin figures at the beginning, which, you know, are pretty much handmade, homemade toys. And they pour them into molds at home. He's got just really mythical creatures like the Poopicorn, I believe. And
I don't know what that means.
Unicornosaurus or Rainbowosaurus. But anyway, probably his most... let's get these down. Probably his most popular figure at the time, anyway. They sell out when they come out. Is the Killer and the Sleeping Killer, which we have here. This is called... it came from the Crocus 2 set. So basically you got two of them, and I have to tell you, I was a big fan of this figure, the Sleeping Killer, and this is the Walking Killer. And they're kaiju pieces. It's that soft plastic that we were talking about. It's not vinyl, it's hollow. It's not vinyl like, you know, your designer rotocast vinyl. Exactly. But really cool guy, really fun, whimsical things, and he's got all sorts of different sprays and colorways. But basically, the bottom has the feet going like this, so kind of like rock on, crossing the arms, like, you know. But I always wanted a Killer, and so I just waited until a good package came out. I emailed him, and if you email him, he's a really, really, really great guy. You know, he'll just be personable with you. But he told me that the next release was coming up and that it was going to be $90. Jimmy, what do you think about paying $90 for these two pieces of plastic?
First, I want to say, let's stop saying whimsical.
Yes.
I don't know when we could possibly ever have to use that again. $90 for this. I mean, they're very light, you know. They're you know, they're not bad, you know, put together, but you can tell, I mean, $90. I mean, where does the demand come from for that, and why is that price what it is?
You know, basically it's the man and the name behind the figure. And I just thought I'd bring it up because, you know...
This one turns two. You can tell me this one turned two.
Yeah, they do have one point of articulation. There's been a mashup done, which is basically where Bonner will take the tail off of one and put it on the head of another. I think one's been called the Moon Eater. He took the tail of this and made it the head or something of the next figure with eyes.
I mean, are there other ones, or are they just like this? Because it seems kind of like evolution, you know, like they're getting legs and like moving. Is there more? They're just this in different colorways?
There's a giant killer that I believe is about yay big. Other than that, this is what you're dealing with. The sleeping killer is the most common. These are the walking killers, and they're commanding a really good price too, like 40, 50, 60 and up. But, yeah, I do really like Buana, and I like what he's doing, and he's affiliated with great artists, and, you know, he's doing his thing, and when I can afford it, I get his pieces. So, Buana, send us an email, vinylfugazi@gmail.com, and I'll review your other stuff, you know?
Awesome.
I really do like the figure, and that's about all I got to say.
It's got the crossed legs underneath. I did not see that before.
Mm-hmm. These are once again sprayed with airbrush, you know, classic kaiju airbrush type style. But, speaking of that, the next piece is the Toasted Marshall. And if you don't know, let me read the back for you. Marshall Mashumaro was a little boy who ate so many marshmallows, he turned into one. How scary is that? But he's just about the cutest little marshmallow boy ever. I said cute now. Whimsical, now cute. We hope you enjoyed this special toasty version of Marshall, but remember, even though he may look good enough to eat, he's really just plastic and does not taste good at all. Made in China and hand-toasted, really it's just paint, at Squibbles Inc. Studios in the United States. So this is a product that says it all, basically, but Roto Fuji is involved with this again, one of our, you know, favorite shops. They hand-spray these, and you want to open that up, Jim?
Nicely.
Yeah, please. It's got a header card and a bag, just like, you know, a lot of kaiju might. Basically, they came out with a blind box series of the Marshalls where they had 15 or 16 different designs, I think. There was pirates, and one was all dazed out, one was beat up, one was plain, one was, you know, all that. I got one, I got the pirate. And, yeah, then next thing you know, they had a small run of these, where they sprayed them out to look like toasted marshmallows, and I thought, that's awesome, you know? So I was going to get one, and in about a week's time, maybe a week and a half, they were sold out. So I thought, man, and they said, don't worry, you know, it'll be soon, we'll make another batch. And I waited, I think, over a year or something like that. Maybe I missed a batch, but I didn't see them again. So the other day, I heard on a Tuesday they were having them. So $15 a piece, I grabbed a couple, and they showed up right at my doorstep. And pretty much the awesomest thing ever, I tuned in back again on Thursday, and they were sold out again. It said they made 60 of them this time, sold out in 2 days. So...
What does this 64 colors mean here on the back?
I was waiting for you to ask me about that, huh? 64 colors...
I gotta know.
If you go on the internet and you Google 64 colors, they do the amazing customs, mostly of this figure since it's their platform toy, their signature toy. But they've made a lot of them to look like wood grain or tree stumps or, you know, all sorts of stuff. Sometimes pretty girls' faces with, like, leaves and bark around it. But 64 colors is amazing. Their customization is known as just top quality in the world of the customization. So, check them out. Go look at 64 Colors. You know, we check out all these artists that we...